I remember when I took my Nitrox course back around 1999, 2000, somewhere in there. You know, Nitrox at that point was very new to a lot of divers in the recreational realm. And Nitrox allows us to do longer dives, it allows us to do safer dives. As I was walking through some of the calculations in your paperwork, it seemed like some of you guys are struggling with understanding how to figure out some of the basic calculations for nitrox. So I want to show you something that's really simple to use. And for me, it was a lot easier than trying to use any kind of a handheld non-electronic calculator such as a wheel or tables, or try to figure things out using long division. So what we're going to do in this session is we're going to talk about the magic wheel for nitrox. Using the magic wheel, find the solution for maximum operating depth. Now, this is going to become very important for you as you start diving more nitrox. And when you start taking more technical classes, you're going to find that having a solid understanding of some of these formulas is going to be really helpful for you. So the first thing we're going to use is what is called the magic wheel. And the magic wheel has three components. It's basically, it's a circle, looks like a wheel. And then we're just going to go in and we're going to draw a T in that. And then there's some things here, especially when we're figuring out maximum operating depth, that are going to be constants. The top part, that's always going to be our partial pressure of O2. And then on the left-hand side, that's going to be the nitrox blend. And then for this formula, on the right-hand side, it's going to be maximum operating depth. Now, just to foreshadow a little bit some of the other things that we'll be doing with the wheel, we need to have an understanding that anytime we move from the top, where we have partial pressure of O2, and we move down, we always divide. If we're going to move from left to right or from right to left, we always multiply. And you'll see that in some of the other modules that we're going to cover. So for a sample, finding the maximum operating depth. And here we're using 32 mix. So we're going to be stable with the partial pressure of 1.4. We don't ever want to go over 1.4. As you've learned in some of your other workshops, and as you will continue to learn, that really going over that 1.4 puts us at risk of oxygen toxicity. So we have our partial pressure of 1.4 for oxygen, and then we're going to divide that by our 32 mix. And when we do that, essentially what we do is we take that 32 mix and turn it into a decimal. So 1.4, and again we divide by 0.32, and what that's going to give us is 4.375. Now that's not in feet. Otherwise, this is really not a good gas for us, right? It only allows us to dive, less than 4.5 feet of water. Now what that is, if you think back to when we've had to convert atmospheres, when we're working with some of the Boyle's Laws questions, that is our atmospheric pressure. So when we take 1.4, divide by 0.32, we get 4.375. And in order to convert that, what we're going to do is take that 4.375 minus 1, which gives us 3.375. And then remember, this is where we're going to do the division, 3.375, or as you were, the multiplication, 3.375 times 33. What that does is it gives us 111 feet of salt water. If we want to find this out for fresh water, then we'd simply divide or multiply that by 34. So again, that's the magic wheel for nitrox. What you should be able to do at this point is use the magic wheel to find the solution for your maximum operating depth. What questions do you have?